everyone, Ella here, and welcome to bplus podcast. Be a blessing, be a blessing, be a blessing to everyone. Be a blessing, be a blessing, be a blessing to everyone. Be a blessing. To everyone. Be a blessing, be a blessing, be a blessing to everyone. Be a blessing, be a blessing, be a blessing to everyone. Hi everyone, so generations of Catholics have admired this young saint and called her the Little Flower. Kumaon siya si Saint Therese of Lisieux or Saint Therese of the Child Jesus. Kuan, Little Flower of Jesus kay tungod, usa siya ka simple nga white flower sa forest and field, unnoticed by the greater population, yet growing and giving glory to God. Yet, Therese died when she was only 24, and after having lived as cloistered Carmelite for less than 10 years, she never went on a missions, never founded a religious order, never performed great works, and the only book of hers published after her death was an brief edited version of her journal called Story of a Soul. But within 28 years of her death, the public demand was so great that she was canonized. So, Therese was born in France in January 2, 1873. The pampered daughter of a mother who had wanted to be a saint and a father who had wanted to be a monk. But now, both of her parents were canonized to sainthood on October 18, 2015 by Pope Francis. So, maong pampered daughter si Saint Therese kay tungod siya ang youngest daughter sa Martins, ug pagkaanak sad niya, she was weak and frail, and doctors feared for the infant life. Tungod sa previous na panghitabo sa ilang family, parehas atong namatay iyang upat ka igsoon, ila nang gi-prepare ilahang self sa ilang sa laing kinabuhi na mamatay. Ni ana iyang mama na si Saint Zelie sa iyahang 3 months old nga girl nga si Saint Therese, ana siya nga, "I have no hope of saving her. The poor little thing suffers horribly, and it breaks your heart to see her." But Saint Therese proved to be much tougher than anyone realized. She survived the illness. Therese thrived on the love which surrounded her in this Christian home. It was here where prayer, the liturgy, and practical good works formed the basis of her own ardent love for Jesus, her desire to please Him and the Virgin Mary. Tragedy and loss came quickly to Therese when her mother died of breast cancer when she was 4.5 years old, and her 16 years old sister Pauline, na nahimo niyang second mother after namatay yang mama, isud sa convent sa Carmelite after 5 years. So a few months later nga isud si Pauline sa Carmelite, Therese became so ill with a fever that people thought nga mamatay siya. So when Therese saw her sister praying to the statue of Mary in her room, nag-ampo sa si Saint Therese nga ni pray siya sa Virgin Mary nga maayo siya sa iyang sakit. And then iyang nakita ang face ni Mama Mary nga ni smile og ni radiate og naayo si Saint Therese. Without realizing it, by the time she was 11 years old, she had developed the habit of mental prayer. She would find a place between her bed and the wall in the solitude think about God, life, and eternity. When her other sisters, Marie and Leon, left to join religious orders, the Carmelites and the poor clerics respectively, Therese was left alone with her last sister, Celine, and her father. Therese tells us that she wanted to be good, but that she had an odd way of going about. This poor little queen of her father's wouldn't do housework. So she thought if she made the beds, she was doing a great favor. So diri ga start iyang mga little things. So every time Therese even imagined that someone was criticizing her or didn't appreciate her, she burst into tears. So, naay time nga si Saint Therese mag-emotional outburst. Kanang mag-guan sa siya, mag-cry sa siya kay tungod, nanong muhilak siya. So, ini inner wall she built to contain her wild emotions crumpled and immediately before the tiniest comment. So, moto, si Therese wanted to enter the Carmelite convent to join Pauline and Marie. But, saon daw niya pagsud sa convent or pag-survive sa Carmelite life if di sa niya ma-handle ang iyahang emotional outburst. So, nag-pray si Saint Therese ni Jesus ug nangayo siyang sign. So, on Christmas Day in 1886, na may tradition ang France nga. Young children left their shoes by the hearth of the Christmas and then parents would fill them with gifts. So, mauto ang iyahang sister nga si Celine nagbilin og gift dito para ni Therese. So yun, katong padung na sila sa stairs to take off their hats, niya na ilang papa nadungga ni Therese and ni Celine. Niya na siya nga, thank goodness, that's the last time we shall have this kind of thing. Moto, both katong nga gisulti siyang papa nadungga ni Therese ug ni Celine. Na nagtuo si Celine nga magbuhat og tantrums or muhilak si Therese kay emotional gani kay siya. But na-amaze si Celine kay at that time, wala ni hilak si Therese. Niya na si Therese nga, Jesus had come into her heart and done what she could not do herself. He made her more sensitive to her father's feeling than her own. So katong nga Christmas, moto ang time sa iyahang conversion. Gitawag si Therese nga little flower, but she had a will of steel. Niadto siya sa superior sa Carmelite para mo mananghid na mo sud siya sa minister sa Carmelite monastery pero wala man ni sugot ang superior kay bata pa kay si Therese. Moto kay wa man ni sugot ang sa Carmelite adto siya sa bishop. Then pag adto sa niya sa bishop, wasa siya sugti kay tungod kay bata palagi siya. Moto ni adto siya sa pope. Iyahasang papa nga supportive kay niya ug iyang sister ngadto sila sa pilgrimage dito sa Rome ug ilang gikuyugan si Therese. Dito ilang nakita ang pope dayon dito na kuan si Therese nga nananghid siya sa pope pero ang pope ang advice sa pope niya na ra siya nga follow kung unsay giingon sa superior. Then amay usa dito nga pari na nakakita ni Saint Therese dayon na impress siya sa will sa bata nga musud sa convent. Moto, after ana, nakadawat si Therese nga pwede na siyang musud sa Carmelite. Then dito, pagsud niya sa Carmelite, nag-suffer si Saint Therese kanang ng spiritual dryness. Niya na siya nga, Jesus isn't doing much to keep the conversion going. Conversation going. Na ay time nga during sa ilahang communion ay kanang mag-pray sila tanat sa Carmelite, makatug siya. Then ni ana si Therese nga, as the mothers love children when they lie asleep in their arms, so that God must love her when she sleep during prayer. So mani, kaninga thought iyang gihimo nga consolation sa iyahang self. Dayon kabaw si Therese na as Carmelite nun, she would never be able to perform great deeds. Sama siya nga, love proves itself by deeds. So how am I to show my love? Great deeds are forbidden me. The only way I can prove my love is by scattering flowers. And these flowers are every little sacrifice, every glance and word, and the doing of the least action for love. So she took every chance to sacrifice, no matter how small it would seem. She smiled at the sister she didn't like. She ate everything she was given without complaining, so that she was often given the worst leftovers. One time, she was accused of breaking a vase when she was not at fault. So instead of arguing, she sank to her knees and begged for forgiveness. These little sacrifices cost her more than bigger ones, for this went unrecognized by others. No one told her how wonderful she was for this little secret humiliation and good deeds. So ato nga time nga iyahang sister nga si Pauline na himog prioress, ni Asha ni Therese nga magpabilin as novice. So, kani siya, kay great sacrifice ni siya. Yang being a novice is never fully professed nun, that she would always have to ask permission for everything na iyang buhaton. So, after said ato nga time, kay namatay man ang iyahang papa, ang iyahang igsuon na si Celine ni sudsad sa Carmelite. So, all of the five sisters ni sud sila pagkamadri. So, at that time, there is worry about how she could achieve holiness in the life she lead. Dili siya ganahan nga, buutan ra siya, ganahan jud siyang magpakasantos. So, ningita siya gway unsaon niya pagsantos sa iyahang little ways nga buhaton. Padayon na siya, God would not make me wish for something impossible. And so, in spite of my littleness, I can aim at being a saint. I will look for some means of going to heaven by a little way, which is very short and very straight, a little way that is quiet in you. So nag-thought siya nga, kuan at that time kay na may mga age of invention man to man siya nga, we need no longer climb laborious up flights of stairs. In will to do houses, there are lifts, and I was determined to find a lift to carry me to Jesus, for I was far too small to climb the steeps of perfection. So I sought in the Holy Scriptures some idea of what this life I wanted would be. And I read these words, whosoever is a little one, come to me. Mato na realize ni Therese na sa arm ni Jesus, mauto ang lift na muda niya dito sa heaven. And niya na siya nga, I must stay little and become less and less. Then in 1896, dito na nag-start ang sakit ni St. Therese. Po iya na ninggi keep sa iyang self-worth niya gi kuan gipahibaw sa iyang other nuns nga kuyog. She keep on working without telling anyone. Dayon, at despite sa iyang sakit, she tried to remain smiling and cheerful. Her one dream was the work she would do after her death. Kay, ana siya nga, I will return and my heaven will spend on earth. So, maski mamatay siya, magbuhat siya og miracle diri sa earth. Ngunang kuan, shower of roses. So, Therese passed at 7:20 p.m. on September 30, 1897. And her final words were, oh my God, I love you. So within months nga namatay si St. Therese, kuan na publish ang iyahang kuan katong iyang story of soul. Dun mao na iyang usa nga libro. Then kato siya nga libro mao nag-cause nga kuan siya for beatification and canonization grew at the beginning of the 20th century. So a thousand of letters poured into the Carmel monastery in Lisieux. Canonization took place on May 17, 1925 at St. Peter Basilica, Rome. Her little way is about childlike trust and gentle love. She is the great apostles of faith in God's love, not simple reliance on physical signs. And Therese of Lisieux is the 33rd and youngest doctor of the church. She received this title from Pope John Paul II on October 19, 1997. And to be a doctor of the church, a saint must recognize by the church as someone who has made a profound contribution to our understanding of God through their writings, study, or research. So since there is simple and practical approach to spirituality through her little way had a huge impact on thousands of the faithful. And Saint Therese is one of the patron saints of the mission, not because she ever went anywhere, naka-cloister siya, tungod ni sa iyang special love for the missions and the prayers and letters nga iyang gihatag to support the missionaries. And this is a reminder to all of us who feel we can do nothing, that it is the little thing that keep God's kingdom growing. Her little way teaches us to do the ordinary things of life with extraordinary love. That's all for today, and I hope you learned something. Be a blessing, be a blessing, be a blessing to everyone. Be a blessing, be a blessing, be a blessing to everyone. be a blessing. To everyone, be a blessing, be a blessing, be a blessing to everyone. Be a blessing, be a blessing, be a blessing to everyone.